have a few questions for you. This is Roosevelt with AutoNetwork, and we're here in New York City with Jeep. And we have good buddy Ralph again, designer, extraordinaire. Ralph, in this day and age with AI, how did AI or has AI played any into the design?
Well, the current vehicle that we're launching today, we designed our part of it, was done about 3.5 years ago, and engineering took it over. So AI was not really a thing yet. Today, we're using AI as a search tool for ourselves. So we can load, we actually have what we call captive AI. So we use the AI algorithms, but our IT team has actually developed something that's within our own walls. So we can actually feed our AI with our own sketches, our own historical vehicles. And we use it almost like, if you have two designers project, it's almost like a third designer that brings in a perspective that you may not have stumbled on. And it's, of course, it's very fast. I mean, within 30 seconds, you have a lot of ideas. Phenomenal rendering capabilities. So let's say we're embracing AI with no fear. If anything, it's the opposite. We're excited by AI. We tend to be early adopters in our space anyway with technology, whether it's 3D printing. We have all those things. We use every medium we can get our hands on. However, I don't think it'll replace the finessing of a designer, the gut feeling of a designer. She said, yet another tool in an amazing, ever-expanding toolbox.
Well, you know, as a designer, passion has a lot to do with it. You think it's going to maybe remove some of that passion that you're going to see in the younger wannabe designers?
That's a very interesting question, because I happen to be on the board of trustees of my alma mater, CCS, and we have been struggling with that. You know, do we allow the young designer students to use AI or not? What we decided to do was not allow them to use AI in the beginning of their career, to make sure they learn the fundamentals, make sure they understand what true product research is. And as they mature, we start letting them use it. And they actually, if you're a good designer, you're a good designer. It doesn't matter, right? Now, on the other hand, if you use AI and spits out something, let's say, a little bit predictable, that's where we come in and fix that. We can tune it as professionals. We do it all the time. You know, a theme that may look a certain way, that's my job, and that's the job of my design management team to go in there and make the design better, hopefully, as we, you know, develop it.
Now, I noticed you're using a lot of different elements in the Wagoneer, and I want to applaud you for getting away from piano black. Not one of my favorite.
Listening to the customer.
Yeah, but I noticed on the exterior around the wheel well trim, is that a piano black?
Yeah, it's a typical high gloss black.
You moved it from the outside.
Yeah, it makes it a little more resistant to scarring and stuff and cleanability.
So, I didn't get a good look at the dash. Is that piano black as well around?
No, it's a lens. It sort of is, in a way, piano black, but it's out of, you don't really touch that area much.
Okay.
The areas that are high, let's call it high traffic, we came up with this new ceramic-coated material, which is extremely durable, and just by the nature of its texture, is not fingerprinted, right? So that's the one complaint we've gotten about piano black. People have to clean it all the time to make it look brand new again.
Yeah, I'm always looking at it from a cleaning standpoint. I'm glad you mentioned that.
Yeah, and I'm a fussy guy. I like my car really clean.
And some of the other materials that you've come up with, like you said, you have the granite now.
Yeah.
In terms of reliability, durability, and more importantly, being able to replace those tactile elements. Is that going to be something easy to do?
We hope you don't ever have to replace it. You know, hopefully they last the life of the car. That's the idea. So we have some pretty stringent testing. Once in a while, we'll experiment with things that are a little exotic. Let's say on our very niche, like SRTs, we have some stuff there. But for most of our mainstream vehicles, we have very, very stringent testing at the moment. The part should last.
Talk a little bit more about why you're so enthusiastic about the wing.
I love it because it's one of those details that it didn't set out initially to be iconic. It was something to correct the parts. I really don't think for this type of vehicle, we saw it in clinics, people don't like the tapered backlights that much because they feel the car looks a little apologetic somehow. So allow us to keep the character of the car, make it have that kind of a traditional SUV silhouette, but yet enjoy the benefits of a tapered design for aerodynamics. And the end result, it looks very futuristic. So when you're driving behind the vehicle on the freeway, you'll know it's a Wagoneer S, 50 yards away.
And last question on your front design, like you mentioned in the presentation, there is no need for cooling.
Yeah.
and you have a unique design. I guess you replaced the traditional grill with I would call it a more modern style. How did you come up with that?
Well, it was exactly that. We realized that the vehicle had no badge. We said, hey, we have to design a Jeep that doesn't need a badge. Now, sometimes we put it for regional reasons to keep our name out there, but we should know it's a Jeep without a badge. That's the whole idea of the 7-slot grill. So we kept iterating and iterating, and then Eugenio came up with this idea of a smaller grill, but we thought, how can we make it more modern? So we're using light technology and then using the cast lighting, automatically became recognizable, number one, two, iconic. Even when the car is off and the lights aren't on, the detail is really cool because it has this cantilevered sharp nose that is, I think, going to become iconic over time.
So what do you find on the new Wagoneer, the Wagoneer S, the big smile on you? One or two.
I love how it stayed true to the original sketch. That's why we showed the sketch today. The pencil sketch was so clean, so efficient. And I'm excited because I'm a big believer that you have to leave a little room in good design, which means don't overstyle. So the customer can see what they want to see in the vehicle, and we can also expand its personality in different directions if the initial design isn't overwrought. And you see that the example we showed today was the Trailhawk. It has, we pump up the capability with some details and some wheel flares, lift it, and all of a sudden it becomes a real rough and tumble Jeep. Now, on the other hand, I can go another way and make it very luxurious. You look on the speed, you do some polished wheels, you change the color of the DLO surround, and all of a sudden it becomes a little more, even more pretty. The one we have upstairs is like a blackout trim version, and then you go on from there. So I look at that as a canvas, and we're about to start developing the story of Wagoneer S for years to come.
Great. Thanks, Ralph. Appreciate it. Always a pleasure seeing you.
Well, best to you.
Thanks.